Hello everybody. I want to thank, first of all, the members of the jury for accepting the Dutch number work. And then I want to thank also the audience for the presence. Today, we're about the subject.
By developing new time block templates.
using the SAP Crystal Reports. Okay, the migration lifecycle. The first part is analyzing the data, analyzing the environments, and meeting the requirements for the migration, like buying new servers, new routers, and so on. The data collection. In the data collection, we should collect data of the old system, but passing by the users of production to validate data and to fill some Excel files, macro files, in order to load them into the new system. And instead of data loading, there is two parts of data loading: loading the configuration systems to make the new system works as it should, then giving a copy of the WIP work in process of the old system, loading it into the new system to perform tests and validation with the production users. Then this is from data collection to test and validation. This is a loop while looping engine. We have a stabilized version of the system. Then we decide to migrate the system into production, and after that we go to stabilization and optimization step. Okay, for project management, it's not really clear. I divided the project into sub-projects, then some tasks. Okay, this is the work breakdown structure. It's not clear because there is a problem with Photoshop. This is the Gantt diagram, just given each task the required time to perform it. Strategy and solution choice. The solution is the factory works. Step 2. The solution is a new package of manufacturing management that comprises an improved version of the MAS and other components, as I said, to meet the current need of STMicro electronics. This is the database architecture. The factory work step 2 has 3 databases. Okay. There is a database that doesn't show. There is the EMS PRD, it's the EMS database of production. The schema is factory work system 2. And there is RDB PRD, which is the database of the reporting. And ODS, which is an integration database. The RDB and ODS are a copy of the MS PRD, this one for reporting, and this one to communicate to external systems. In order not to disturb the production. Okay, FactoryWorks 2 models. FactoryWorks 2 provides a lot of models that meets the requirements of STMicro electronics production, like site modeling. Since ST has multiple sites around the world, there is site modeling. There is process planning for the management of production processes, working process tracking, the real-time tracking of the loss in the production, operator tracking for certifications, equipment monitoring for controlling the equipment via EMCS, which is the equipment monitoring control system, and other components. Choosing the strategy of migration. Due to other sites migration, because the STMicro electronics to Skoda is the last backend that migrates to this factory works too. There is other sites, other backends that has already done this work. Then they have an experience, they give it to STMicro Skoda, and they take advantage of it. In other sites, there were another strategy of line by line migration. That we stop a system in one line of production, we migrate, and then we go to the other line and so on. But in STMicro Skoda, they decide to have a big bang strategy. A big bang strategy consists on stopping all the lines, migrating the system and opening the system. This is critical, but we have taken all the requirements to be safe and to be in time. The difference between the two strategies, line by line, which is requires more costs and more time, while the Big Bang, the time and the cost are reduced. Okay, the solution of reporting, this is one of the solutions I proposed. The reporting is the production database, I mean the RDB, not the MSDB. The reporting database, we developed some PSQL functions that fill the tables of the reporting. Then there is PHP scripts that generates the report either on web form, HTML format or Excel format. Then there is a mechanism of archiving mechanism to the server and sending the results to the managers in order that they take advantage of these reports to make their decisions. This is now the design of the model. This is an example of the ERD, of the equipment management. And in the report, there is all the ERD of factory work step 2. This is the reporting use case. Reporting set sequence diagram. It is simple, but it is useful for the managers. For the tablets, I was working on templates with the SAP Crystal Reports. This is the design of tablets. First of all, we add the tables, then we link the tables, then we make advantage of this link to put data in the detailed sections, in the header sections, in order to produce the document I gave you before. Realization. This is the tools, SQL Developer, Oracle Database, SQL Loader for data loading, HP for reporting, PHP for reporting, Python scripting for some optimization, Crystal Reports for Dropbox, and Unix scripts for automating the execution of PHP in order to generate reports. This is the Crystal Report template. This is a header filled with some data. These data are used in the production processes, like there is some codes that are used in other systems in order to have some map of like sewing the wafer. This is the result. We have a result of the paper. Reporting development. First of all, developing PSQL functions, then developing PHP scripts, and see the result, then testing the result with the user, of course, then developing Unix script to automate the process. This is the result on HTML. Some example of HTML plating report. It's a report that gives the time that a lot has spent on a step, which is called plating. After finishing the troubles and reporting on all our realization, there is a conformity validation process with the users. We have some meetings, verifications. If there is some non-conformity, we gotta update our work until having it as it should be. Okay, in the migration, we spoke about data logging. This is the data logging process. There is a problem of data shop. You cannot say the schema as it should be. There is some schema there not showing. So system is the old system. This environment, there is the data logging, data collection, collecting the data from the system by users, not by the IT team. By users. Then the user send to us the macro files. Then we perform the data loading, configuration data loading first. Then we take the WIP, the current WIP working process, We load it via a migration tool that is based on a macro file that maps the actual state of the SPN like to the factory works new state, because there were some changes in the database and there is some fields in new tables and so on. There is a loop, as I said here, to test environment. After the data loaded and web loaded, we open the system to the users in order to practice. The users are the key users that we were training. We open to them the system to practice and to execute the test scenarios that were written by the engineering department. In the day of migration, there were pre-migration checks and migration and post-migration. In the pre-migration, we were having the SPN like. We were cleaning the system from all the lots that have any problems of quality, which is held somewhere in some step, in some process. Because in order not to make the migration tool fail during the migration, after cleaning the system, we start the migration, not the migration of the configurations, because the data loadings of the migration of the configurations had stopped in a stable state. We migrate the web, the current web, and in the post-migration we perform some checks on the data in order not to have a lot of errors while practicing in the production. To respond to the requirements of control equipment control, ST decided to put a micro terminal on each equipment. In the old system, there were an operator client. Each line had one computer, and the operators, after finishing its step, her step, she goes to the computer to do the step in the computer. But there is some operators that doesn't do that. That makes us lose the real-time tracking of the production. So ST decided to lock this control. It does not give to operators any possibility to perform anything on the equipment if she does not pass through the macro terminal. In the macro terminal, this set requires some configurations. It wasn't done by the IT team, but some operators were installing the operation systems and putting the factory works clients and installing the macro terminals on the lines. And our job was to follow in the advancement states of this work before the time of the migration. After the migration, there was a stabilization and optimization step, which consists of collecting all user complaints about the problems and errors. Then we perform some solutions, like we're having a problem in the log file of Starbucks printing. This log file contains all the printing errors and informations. The problem were that when the operators or a supervisor perform print on chart log and they don't have any feedback, the printer doesn't print out any paper, they don't know what is the problem, but in the log file, the errors are there. So I developed a Python script that extracts the errors and put them in Excel files, and then given them to IOG group, which are responsible for automation, and the same problem for empty configurations. Conclusion and perspectives. The perspectives of FactoryWorks is to be integrated to all ST corporate systems. in order to meet STEAM requirements and strategies. In conclusion, for me, I grasped a lot from this experience, either on the professional level by exploring the world of industrial distributed systems, either on a personal level by improving my communication skills. Finally, I want to thank you for your attention, and I want to thank the jury for judging this number one.